In this video, I will show you exactly how to use Genially to create beautiful, clickable, gamified and media-rich experience made in moments. So I'll show you exactly how you can use this tool. So first, what's it for? You can see you can use it for business, schools, university or design. I will go over to the university section and you can see you can succeed with your presentations by creating your presentations with Genially. So let's just go ahead and click on try Genially for free. Now first you need to go ahead and sign up, so I'm just going to sign up with my Google account. Now here, what are you going to use Genially for? So education or corporate? For this example, I will use education. Now how would you describe yourself? So in my case, I can pick teacher, student, coordinator, management, instructional designer or other. I'm going to select student. Now at what educational stage are you? I'm going to say university. So now you're all set to start, so click start right here. And now first we are going to search for a template for our presentation or infographic or whatever you want to create. So first just pick what you want to create. I'm going to select a presentation. Now here you will have some templates for your presentation. Now as you can see, some of these are in the premium plan and for this you will need to upgrade to premium. So for example, if I like the essential dark presentation right here, I can click view template. You can select a color palette. And if you like this one, for example, just click use this template. So now you can go ahead and add pages. So you have a cover page, summary, index, text and image 2, and a bunch of different ones right here. Now, for example, I like this one right here, the timeline, relevant data, and of course, I also want a cover and summary. Now I want to add in the graphic, and let's say I would like to do an interactive question. So then click on add. So now you have added these 6 questions right here and it will start with the cover. So now you can simply design your cover right here. So for example, if I have a presentation about the history of space exploration, then here I can enter history of space exploration. Now for example, if I don't like this thing right here, I can just select it and click backspace to remove it. So now you can write a subtitle. I'm just going to keep this like this, but you can simply click on it and write whatever you want. And then here you have the go button and this will take you to the next page. So now I will remove this page since I already have a cover. And now you want to add in your summary and here you can see the images. Now to add an image, simply click on the image, click replace, and now here you can find images so you can search for them and this is powered by Pexels. So these are all free to use images. Now I'm going to search for space since my presentation is about the history of space exploration. So for example, I will add this one and click place. Now as you can see, it has been cropped automatically, but the crop is not perfect, so I'm going to click edit and just crop it like this. So now I will just replace the other 2 images as well. Now if you don't find any good images using the pixels right here, you can also upload from your own device. So I'll use this one and just replace it and do the same process with this image. So now I have some images that actually go along with what I am telling, which in my case is the space exploration. Now I can realign these images however I like, but I kind of like it like this, and I'm going to remove this star here and now go to the next page. So you can see this page has an animation like this, which I really like. So now here you have the buttons where it says plus info. Now this plus info button will review more information. So you can see when I click edit interactivity right here, it will now review more information. So I'll show you what this looks like when I click present and click all set and just go to that page right now. So it's this one and I'll click plus info. It will review the info right here. So you can do this while you are presenting or however you like. So just write whatever you want here. You can change what it says here as well. So for example, click here or whatever you want. So then for the next page, I added in a timeline. So for my presentation, this is perfect since I create a presentation about the history of space travel. So for example, you can do the first moon landing in 1969 and you can add a supporting image. So for example, I would search for Apollo moon landing. Then I can just take an image here. So for example, this is a pretty iconic image. So let's just save this one and upload it on here by clicking replace, then click device, and now you can drag and drop or click right there to upload it. So now as you can see, I have uploaded this image right here. You can also upload multiple images at once. So now I can simply click replace and you will now see this right here. So now I can add 1969 and then for the text right here, for example, add Apollo. So now you can just tell a little bit about this, or where it says plus here, you can select review, and you can see that now it will review this. Now what you can also do is review text. So you can just create an entire text box right here. So now what you can also do, when you click on plus, you can click on edit interactivity, and you can say, for example, go to page, or you can take it to a link or audio, or you can even have it expand to full screen when they click on that. So now just go through and edit all of the graphs and timelines and everything you want until you are happy with what it looks like. Now you can click present, and now you will see what it actually looks like. So you can see the history of space exploration. So now let's just take a look. You can see they all have animations. By the way, if you want to change those animations, you can simply click on the image and then click on the animation button here and then change the animation. For example, if I set it to interactive and then hover mouse, you can now see when I go to present and go to that specific page that when I hover my mouse, it goes up like this. So that's a really nice add-on as well. So now you can see when I click plus info, it will review all of the info here. And now you can see when I click plus here, it will review Apollo, and you can see the time and the image to support it. So just go through and edit all of this. Now you can see in the bottom left, we have the Genially watermark. So if you want to remove this, just go back to the editor and click on upgrade to premium, because for this, you will need to have premium. Now, if you want to change the background for any of your slides, you can see the current background right here, but you can also use an image, for example. As you can see now, this is the background, and you can just do this however you want. You can also choose an image from their library, but I'll just keep it to the document color right here. Now, if you want to share your infographic or a presentation or whatever you created, you can click on the share icon right here and just share the link or share it directly onto the social networks that you want, sent via email or whatever you want. So that's how to use Genially to create interactive infographics, presentations, etc. If this video was helpful, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to my channel. And with that being said, I will see you in the next video.